Welcome to Microwave Engineering Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain microwave transistors, where these are my session outlines, where first I'll explain basics of microwave transistor, then I'll explain construction of different types of microwave transistor, and we'll see some details of microwave transistor, and then we'll compare different parameters of different types of microwave transistors. So let us begin this session. So here I'll be discussing basics of microwave transistor. Now, why do we need to have microwave transistor first of all? So basic reason is we need to have reduction of size of device, that's why we use it. We need to have reduction of packaged plastic reactants, for that we use microwave transistor. And if you reduce packaged plastic reactants, in that case there are some advantages, that is what we need to explore here. For that we build up microwave transistors. We need to reduce transient time. For that basically the purpose of microwave transistor is there. The reason is at microwave frequency is very high, so as frequency is very high we need to decrease transient time. So reduction of transient time, that is so essential. When we talk about structure of microwave transistor, commonly used semiconductor are silicon and gallium arsenide to have a fabrication of microwave transistor. Transient time depends on mobility, and gallium arsenide, that is superior compared to other silicon material like other semiconductor material like silicon or germanium. So gallium arsenide, that is superior. The reason is it offers lower transient time and it is having higher mobility. So transient time, that is low in case of fabrication, is been done by gallium arsenide. Molecular beam epitaxy technique, so that is what we usually utilized, and that is where we have HEMT, high electron mobility transistor. At the end I'll explain what is HEMT, and we can have this device functioning up to 100 gigahertz. So these are the basics which is there regarding microwave transistor. Now let us move on for further part. Now when we talk about different categories of microwave transistor, then we use low noise transistor, and that is what we are utilizing it for, low noise amplifier applications. So low noise transistor, that is been utilized for low noise applications. Low level transistor, that is what we are utilizing for driving IF stage. Power transistor for microwave transistor, that is what we use it for driving power amplifier. So these are the different categories, and these categories we are utilizing for different applications. Like low noise transistor is being utilized for LNA, low noise transistor is being utilized for LNA, low level transistor is being utilized to drive IF stage, and power transistor, that is been utilized for power amplifier. Let us move further. See, microwave ICs, there are basically two categories where we fabricate microwave transistor. One is microwave integrated circuit, MIC, microwave integrated circuit, and second is monolithic microwave integrated circuit. Now when we talk about microwave integrated circuit, in that hybrid soldered lump element and transmission line for a signal transmission is been connected. So lump parameter, lump element like inductor and resistor. So that is what we are connecting along with transmission line, and we provide matching with microwave transistor in microwave integrated circuit. But when we talk about monolithic microwave integrated circuit, in that all active and passive components are fabricated in a single crystal chip. So when we use monolithic microwave integrated circuit, at that time all active and passive components are there in single chip, while in case of microwave integrated circuit we have lumped element like inductor and resistor. That is what we connected with transmission line, and we provide matching network even with a connection of microwave transistor. So this is how IC technologies are there with microwave ICs with microwave transistor. Now in next part, construction of microwave transistor, where there are two categories, bipolar and unipolar. When we talk about bipolar microwave transistor, then there are three semiconductor doping region that is there, like PNP or NPN. In case of unipolar, there is one or two semiconductor doping region is there. In bipolar, we have electrons and holes as a carrier. While in case of unipolar, either we have electron or hole as a carrier. In bipolar, silicon BJT that is available and which is functioning in UHF to S band. In unipolar, silicon BJT or gallium arsenide FET that is there, which is working in S to C band. Bipolar is been utilized for higher gain. Unipolar that is having better noise performance. Unipolar that is having better noise performance, and for high frequency operation we utilized it. So one should know these basics when they have construction of microwave transistor. Bipolar is having three different semiconductor doping region, while in case of unipolar there is one or two semiconductor doping region. In bipolar both of the carriers are there. In unipolar either electron or holes are there. Bipolar BJT works in UHF to S band, while in case of unipolar it works from S band to C band. Bipolar has been utilized to obtain higher gain, while unipolar that is been utilized for better noise performance as well as for high frequency of operation. So this is how construction has been classified. Now when we talk about microwave bipolar transistor, it is there in planar form. I'll show construction so one can see it. Mostly made up of silicon material. When you see its geometry, it is interdigitized overlay and matrix form. So you'll be finding it is interdigitized overlaid and matrix form structure is there, and its bit of cutoff frequency that is there around 22 gigahertz. So its beta cutoff frequency that is there around 22 gigahertz. If you see structure of microwave bipolar transistor, then one can observe here structure where multiple layers are there, N plus diffusion layer, P diffusion layer, N epitaxial layer, N plus substrate layer. That is how layers are there, which is there in matrix form, and it is interdigitized layers. So that is how it is there. And if you see the doping concentration, that even I have shown here, N plus is having higher doping concentration, that is there with 10 to the power 21 doping level, while P that is there with 10 to the power 17 doping level, N layer that is there with 10 to the power 15 doping level concentration, and N plus that is what varying from 10 to the power 15 to 10 to the power 21 doping level. And that is how this micro bipolar transistor that has been fabricated, and its layer with respect to width of layer, that is even I have assigned here, so one can see its construction here. Now when we talk about microwave bipolar transistor, as I have told, its beta cutoff frequency is around 22 gigahertz, and that one can calculate by FT is equals to 1 by 2 pi T, where T is transient time, that is what addition of different time period, where TJEB that is what emitter base junction capacitor charging time. One can neglect it. The reason is it is very small. This TB, that is base region transient time. This TBC, that is base collector region depletion layer transient time. And TJCB, that is base collector junction capacitor charging time. Usually when we design this, at that time we neglect this emitter base junction capacitor charging time. The reason is it is very small. When we talk about unipolar FET, it is usually made up of gallium arsenide. It is having very high mobility. And as we have discussed polar, where usually it is made up of silicon material. For microwave frequencies, Schottky barrier gate FET, commonly called as MESFET, MESFET. It is not MOSFET, it is MESFET, which is what Schottky barrier gate FET. That is working at high frequency compared to polar. It is having high electron mobility transistor. So this is even one category which is there with unipolar FET, HEMT, high electron mobility transistor. At last I will discuss this HEMT. Beta cutoff frequency, that is even there around 22 gigahertz, and that one can calculate as same formula which is there for polar. But here one thing that one can see, unipolar, that is having gain about 10 to 15 dB at 2 gigahertz, and noise figure that is there around 1 dB. So this is how advancement is there. Let us see structure of unipolar FET. So it is having only one polarity is there, where N epitaxial gallium arsenide is there. One can see N epitaxial means it is N type, and there is depletion region at gate, and this is what we are controlling, depletion region, to have flow of current from source to drain. We control depletion region, and this is having only one polarity, N-type layer, one can see. So N-type layer, only single polarity is there. So this is how it is different, while in case of bipolar, there are multiple layers. Now, this is what last point of microwave transistor, which I will be discussing, where HEMT, high electron mobility transistor, that is very well known transistor, that is having gain about 15 dB at 8 gigahertz and 6 dB at 50 gigahertz. And noise figure, that is extremely low at 8 gigahertz, it is 0.4 dB and 1.8 dB at 50 gigahertz. If you see unipolar, then gain is 10 to 15 dB at 2 gigahertz. So lower frequency, that could be preferred for unipolar compared to HEMT. And noise figure is less than 1 dB. And here for HEMT, you can see 0.4 dB at 8 gigahertz, and at very high frequency like 50 gigahertz, noise figure is there around 1.8 dB. And HEMT, that is having multiple layers and matrix structure, that one can see by this basic diagram. Now see here, I am not going to explain you how this device is functioning, that one can easily understand based on semiconductor electronics. But here I am just providing you basic information which will be very helpful to you. And this session that I have prepared based on requirement placed by one of my student, I hope that he would have understood this, and this session might be beneficial to those who are trying to understand what are the basic details that they need to understand microwave transistor. Thank you so much for watching this video. You give your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on that, in future I'll place videos. Thank you so much for watching this video.